An IR camera can provide a lot of information about a PV system, and there are a lot of benefits to using one. First of all, it allows you to test equipment non-destructively, so that you can assess problems without taking things apart. It also gives you an immediate visual cue when there are any anomalies in the system. Results can be trended, compared to previous results, and used to prioritize repairs. And pictures can provide a tangible record of problems in the reports. Overall, an IR camera is a good investment for finding problems more quickly. IR thermography may not be a part of every O&M site visit, but we choose to use it every time because of how cheap and easy it is. In a previous video, we discussed minimum weather requirements we needed to conduct an O&M site visit. These same minimum requirements apply to IR. NFPA 70B suggests that electrical equipment being tested be at least 40% of its maximum load. The closer to fully loaded an array is, the better. It's also ideal to have a very calm day with very low wind. Let's talk a little bit about how IR cameras work. On the surface, they are deceptively simple. It's very easy to point at an object, focus it in, and think that you're done. However, getting an accurate reading on a piece of equipment requires an understanding of all the camera's settings. IR thermography is in some ways almost an art form and can take practice to perform it well. Remember to read and understand your camera's documentation. Many of the major camera manufacturers offer online classes specific to their products, as well as face-to-face trainings and certifications for thermographers. Before shooting with the IR camera, the memory should be cleared. While shooting, the crews document which pictures were taken at which location by the recording of combiner box numbers, the inverter, and the location in the array. Often the camera is used to inspect equipment, but not take IR photos unless there is a problem. It may be enough to record a typical picture to represent what is showing up across the system. Maybe one shot for every 20 combiner boxes, for example. IR thermography of the array usually means taking shots of random modules. The crew might also use the IR camera to take shots of modules when other problems are identified through other means, such as by an IV trace. Because PV modules are essentially big pieces of glass, it's important to remember that your own body heat and other heat sources can easily be reflected in the glass. The camera manufacturer may recommend a particular angle to use when shooting. The company FLIR recommends shooting a module at an angle of 5 to 60 degrees. After the technician has taken thermographic images, they might look for hot spots within a module at a specific cell or other indications of problems. If problems are identified, the crew might isolate the module from the string and do other testing. Before moving on, crews will record locations of any modules that were photographed. Now we're at the combiner box. Ideally, you would take IR images of combiner boxes while they are under load. Sometimes this can be difficult with integrated disconnects. In the case of an integrated disconnect, what you could do is prepare the box, turn it off, quickly open the cover, and take images before heat has a chance to dissipate. Typically located inside of a combiner box is a plastic shield. These plastic shields need to be removed before you can take an accurate IR picture. Important pictures to take include pictures of the fuse holders and all terminations. And remember to record the combiner box identification, for example, combiner box 1. When taking IR images at an inverter, it is possible to open it up while it is running, but it is not recommended. Instead, the crew should keep the cabinet door closed, disconnect power, and efficiently take the reading before the heat dissipates. For this reason, the crew uses the IR camera only on the inverter terminals and fuses, and inspects the other electronics only visually. Again, the crew will document their findings and enter the information into the field report. Software can help crews interpret readings inside the enclosures. Temperatures at specific locations can be highlighted and compared. It's important to note that problems may show up as cool spots, not necessarily warm spots. When something suspicious is noticed at a terminal, crews look for under-torqued or over-torqued connections.